Well, it's a pleasure to have you join us here at the Circuit de Barcelona Catalunya as we proceed through to race day to see just who will claim victory at the Spanish Grand Prix. The Circuit de Barcelona Catalunya then, a high-speed 2.89-mile circuit which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box, and it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into Turn 1. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Young superstar Max Verstappen starts from pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Bottas, Hamilton, Carlos Sainz, and Stroll, Leclerc, Ocon, Fernando Alonso, and Yuki Tsunoda, Norris, Gasly, Daniel Ricciardo, and Vettel, Giovinazzi, Mazepin, George Russell, and Kimi Raikkonen, Mick Schumacher, and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Gap to car in front is 2.2 seconds. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. We're leading our teammate by 11.3 seconds. Thank you. Some information on Mazepin. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Okay, focus. We need to stay on form. Pierre is in for his stop. We're starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. Good job, nice overtake. work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. Teammate behind is 13.0 seconds. Nice move. increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Five laps of fuel remaining. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. This is your final lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 22.2 seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining.
Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
Alphatauri will no doubt be celebrating tonight. What a great win. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
I think we'll chalk this one up to a deft touch on the brake pedal. That's allowed them to challenge down the inside into the braking zones, and ultimately, if you do that often enough, you end up winning the race. It was great to watch as well though, wasn't it? Forget strategy, forget tyre management. Who doesn't love a good old-fashioned scrap?
As we await the winners to take their positions on the podium, one thing is clear. AlphaTauri have really shown their prowess on the track. This is a team that isn't afraid to take risks, whether that's on the circuit or in the new talent they hire. Today, those risks certainly paid off. So, let's review the driver's standings. That lead at the top of the table has shrunk somewhat today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Yuki Tsunoda gets my vote today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Red Bull take over as championship leaders. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.